Hello everyone, welcome back to the Based Digimon channel, and today we have quite the array of goodies to talk about. Let's talk Digimon news.
Oh, sorry, so my sinuses have been very D's lately.
D's what, sir?
D's nuts!
The past few days has been an interesting amount of announcements regarding many different topics. Things such as Digimon Tamers, as many of you might already be familiar with, but there were some other announcements that you might consider to be quite attractive as Digimon fans. Sorry, what was that? Oh, the headphones. Sorry. My bad. I was just, you know, doing what every Digimon fan does. You know how it is? I was just listening to Break the Chain for the 108th time today.
You what?
You know, it just sets the mood quite rightly for me. But I hope you enjoy this kickback video with me talking about some of the things we've seen this week. I hope you enjoy. Okay, let's go through this list, shall we? So first, in no particular order, Digimon Tamers. Now, there is a Digimon Tamers sequel confirmed to be released as an audiobook. Now, this is really fantastic for Digimon Tamers fans, obviously, as the original creator really persisted with this project and really wants an anime sequel as well. So if you're a Tamers fan and you want more, then show your support in this regard. But if you want more detailed information on this topic, please visit DigiKnows channel, as he's done a video on this in a lot more detailed coverage than what I've got for you. Do consider checking out that video after this video is over. But onto the more pressing topics for me personally. Toei have once again released their routinely anime calendar for 2022, and featured on this calendar is Digimon Adventure 2020, Yamato, Gabumon, Agumon, and Taichi from the reboot. Now this is clearly great regardless of the takeaway, but remarkably a lot of people are convinced this means we'll get more things for Digimon Adventure in 2022. Now I'm making this video primarily because this may or may not be the case, but I'll explain why. So I'll refer you to the following calendars. Whilst it does seem like they feature most of their franchises on the calendars regardless of what major projects they have going on, but a lot of the time there has been some either merchandising or announcements that correspond to the franchises being prominent on the calendar, but you know, it's not always as grandiose as we would like. So you know, for example, here on the 2019 calendar, we've got the 1999 Taichi and Agumon, and then this also happened again in the 2020 calendar, we had the 1999 Agumon and Taichi. I suppose you could interpret that as like we had more merchandise in 2019 released. I'm not sure how much or to what extent that is. But in 2020, I suppose you could say it was because of Last Evolution Kazuna, if you want to reach that far. I don't think that was the case, I just think Digimon still pulls in a lot of money for Toei, and it is one of their more prominent franchises regardless of what projects they have out in the years. So they're naturally going to feature Digimon frequently. We don't really know what this could mean. It could either mean a lot or nothing at all. They just make something in that year, and that just confirms our suspicions, right? But it could just be coincidence, remember that. You know, so while it's really nice to have Digimon 2020 on the calendar, and clearly in much more favorable positions and more prominent on these calendars, which is, you know, it's every little win counts for Digimon, but just don't take it too seriously is my only warning. It would be great if we had a sequel in 2022. That would be fantastic. Or for me personally, I would prefer a movie, which is what Toei usually do with their franchises after they finish long series. But if there is any news on this in the future, I will catch you up. But moving on. So whilst I do feel a bit responsible for crushing your hopes and dreams possibly of a sequel in 2022,
this guy stinks
from this whole calendar hype, there is some good news that might make you Digimon fans a bit more elated, almost. I know a lot of you have been waiting for Digimon Survive, and there has been only just recently some announcements on that, and you all are looking forward to it, or at least the majority of you are, but there's another game. There has been an announcement from Move Games developers of an MMO video game based on Digimon Adventure, and it goes by the name of Digimon Super Rumble, and there have been some images released online, shared by various accounts such as With The Will, and it seems to resemble this kind of sandbox style of play, and taking adventure very literally, and it resembles Digimon World in some ways, or at least that's the impression it might give a lot of you. But right now it is being developed for release in South Korea. You know, it's no Digimon Survive, but it's getting a lot of attention on Twitter, ran on the Unreal Engine 4. Once again, like most cool Digimon games that get released, either it's in China or South Korea, is not necessarily available in the West. Or rather, there's no information on that right now. But likelihood is, even if it walks out of the alpha stage, we'll probably only ever see just gameplay of it online. But who knows? But we do have some images of this game ready for you guys to look at. And it had some mixed responses. Considering the kind of game that it is, I don't know why people think it looks bad. You know, I think a lot of these images look very good, and I quite like how it's texturized, and you know, the visuals do look very good, especially the coloration, the detail, and a lot of the areas on the map. And this is an obscure reference, but it definitely gives me kind of Poke Park vibes for Nintendo Wii. I bet none of you have played that game, but it is very similar to what this looks like right now. I mean, I hope it is. It was a good game, to be honest. But yeah, this has definitely piqued my interest. If this actually does become available, I would love to play it. I mean, you guys can let me know what you think of this style and how it looks, but I really like the way this game looks. I don't particularly see anything really wrong with the graphics at all, but obviously these are pre-release images and nothing's finalized yet. So yes, Digimon Super Rumble, an MMO. I guess we've had some bad experiences with MMOs in the past for Digimon. You know, I played Digimon Masters quite a bit, and I think, yeah, it was lacking in some ways, but you know, there's a really strong premise there to do an amazing MMO game for Digimon. It just needs the passion behind it. And this to me looks very promising, but obviously, everyone, let me know in the comments, what do you think of all this news about Tamers? Go check out Diginoa's video. What do you think about the calendar? Do you think it means something? Do you think it's a coincidence? Or do you think it's just more branding, merchandising, capitalizing on the hype that is Digimon Adventure 2020? And then let me know what you think of Digimon Super Rumble. I quite like the look of this, and I'm going to be keeping a close eye on it. So if you want more news on this particular game, let me know, and I'll really kind of hone in on it, and I'll make some updates for you guys. But yes, today, I really hope you enjoyed this quick catch-up news chill video with me. I don't ordinarily do news videos all the time, but this week there was just enough for me to talk about with you lot. But as you know, tomorrow is Sunday. It's the episode 51. Don't miss my review. Be there. Put the bells on. It's going to be a great time. But if you made it this far, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate your time. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Please check out my Twitter at BaseDigimon. We can always talk there. My DMs are open. But I will see all of you tomorrow. And until then, take care.